This is the first lesson of the financial modeling course, and all we're doing in this lesson is we are adding another tab to our financial model, and then we are including all the assumptions as hard codes on the assumptions tab. Okay, so welcome to the first lesson of our back of the envelope beginner financial model. So what we're doing in this lesson, we are inserting a tab, and on this tab, because this is a very simple back of the envelope calculation, we are putting together everything. So all the information on the assumptions and the cash flows will be put together on one tab. So we keep it nice and simple. And in this lesson, we start off by inserting this tab and by putting in all the assumptions on one tab. So let's get started. So the first thing we're doing is we're inserting the tab. So Alt-I-W, there you go, now we've got the tab. And now we move it to the end after the tasks. So move to end, and we're changing the name, and we call it, you know, cash flows, let's say. So now we're on this tab, and we're including the assumptions. So the first thing I want to do is I want to include a header, Alt-HBP, right? So we put a little border here. Now we call this project back of the envelope. Okay, we make this bold, and then we present all numbers in thousands, euros, thousands, and whoops, thousands, another zero. We put this in italics, and the project name is in bold. And let's put the font, we can probably keep it in Calibri. And now let's include the assumptions. So we're actually not modeling anything at this stage. So all we're doing is we're putting the assumptions on the Excel spreadsheet so that we can then afterwards use those assumptions to model out our cash flows. And we group those assumptions into different categories. And the first category is just simply what I call the acquisition assumptions. Acquisitions, the second one, I call them general assumptions. Then I call the third one rental assumptions, or just rents. Then assumptions that are related to the financing, and then assumptions that are related to the exit, and then additional assumptions on OPEX and other fees. So those are the buckets into which I group my main assumptions. And the first one is under the acquisitions assumptions, the obviously the purchase price. And the task is, for now, can we pay 90 million euros for this asset? So we put in the 90 million euros, which, because we're putting in our numbers in thousands, we're just putting in 90,000, right? And now I changed the color to blue because that is the color code for assumptions. And if you want to look at the color code for the assumptions, then you can check this here, more colors, custom. So the color code for assumptions is 00255. So that's the color code for the assumptions. And that's the same color that we use for all assumptions. So this sort of blue. Okay, so we've got the purchase price, then the red, which are the real estate transfer taxes. And we use real estate transfer taxes of 5%. Okay, then we have additional DD costs. So DD is our due diligence cost, so cost to essentially identify any potential risk of this investment. And we're assuming for now simple 250,000 euros or pounds, euros actually, 250,000 euros of due diligence costs for this investment. Okay, and now in general assumptions, we are putting in the modeling start date, which in this case study is December 23. Okay. And then the total surface area of this building, so the gross lettable area, or GLA, is 10,000. Okay. So we always put in a 1,000 separator. And so those are general assumptions. Then under rents, we put in the rents per square meter per month, which are 30. Yeah, 30. Then the rental growth, or the indexation, if you like, which is 3%. Then the inflation, which is 4%. So we grow our costs by the inflation. And when you have leases, often you grow your leases, or you index your leases by the rate of inflation as well. Then we have the occupancy. And we assume an occupancy of 100% because this is a single lease. And then the lease length in years, which is 10 years. So 10. Okay. Now let's move over to the financing. So the LTC, so the loan to cost financing that is available, is 50%. Then the interest rate, so the cost of debt that we have to pay on the loan amount, is 4%. Then the next bucket are the exit assumptions. So we assume an exit yield, so the yield at which we value the asset at sale, of 3.5%. So what we do with the 3.5% is when we sell the asset, we capitalize the net operating income by dividing the NOI at sale by the 3.5%. And this then gives us our exit valuation. So the valuation at which we can sell the asset to the next buyer. And that's a very big assumption. And the math is very simple, but there's a lot of sort of theory and a lot of technical knowledge behind 3.5%. And that is discussed in more detail in my financial modeling courses of my RIA platform. So there's an entire course just on the exit valuation. But for now, we keep it really simple. And all we're doing is we're applying the 3.5% without thinking too much why we're actually using the 3.5%. But there's a lot of theory behind this. Then the exit costs are 1%. So usually when you sell an asset, there are certain costs involved for legal documents. You have to pay lawyers. Then sometimes you run sort of a competitive process, so you have to pay advisors as well. But for now, we're simply assuming the 1% of exit costs. And then when do we actually sell the asset? And we sell the asset in year 5. Okay. And then the final bucket of the assumptions are the asset management fees, which are 6%. Okay, and then the OPEX costs per annum. So the additional OPEX costs that are not covered in this case by the tenant. And those are 250,000 euros per annum of OPEX costs. So often you have something that's called triple net leases, where the tenant covers all OPEX costs. But in this case, we're not having a triple net lease. So a certain OPEX cost that the landlord, so in this case, the private equity investor, has to pay for. And those are additional costs that we need to model. Okay, and so what are those OPEX costs? So this can be the main OPEX costs that you typically have to include in your financial model are sort of repair and maintenance, utility costs, insurance, property taxes. So those are the main costs, and we just group them into OPEX costs. Now let's make sure that we format everything nicely. So we align this to the center. And we do the same with all the others. Align to the center, align to the center, align to the center. Okay, now we put a border around this. Okay. And I press F4 always to repeat the action. Now we do a single accounting here and we change the color to some gray color. And now we copy over the formatting across all those boxes. So we go Control C, and then we copy this over by clicking Alt ES, and then copy over format. And then again, F4, F4 to repeat the last action. And that's pretty much it. Let's make sure the column width is better, a little bit wider. And this is the first lesson. So all we've really done is we've used the assumptions. So from down here, we've used the assumptions and we've copied in the numbers on a new sheet. And so now we have all the assumptions on a separate tab, and that makes it now easy to forecast our cash flows because we have all the assumptions on one sheet, and we will use those assumptions to model our or to project our cash flows in this lesson. Okay, and so this is the first lesson.